on! Charlie Banfield will take it to distance.
Got a man in the back of the end zone. He catches it.
Oh, touchdown! Yes, he got a foot down.
Oh, there's Maxfield back. He's got Wiley.
Oh, he's open.
Wiley is open.
I think it's a foot
down
race. It's a foot
race. Wiley
oh, he stretches out at the end. What a play.
And he's got pressure. He's going to turn around. He's down. Oh, he didn't even see it.
Oh, that was a stop bubble. That's what you look for.
It's going to be a foot race. He's turning on the Jets. Oh, he's gone. He is gone. It's win time.
Yeah. is a blue. Shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck, and you're not moving anywhere. You thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return for grace. It's a beautiful. Yeah.
just an Eddie Cleaver, light on his feet. A young fighter screaming, with no time for doubt. With the pain and anger, can't see a way out. It ain't much I'm asking, I heard him say, gotta find me a future, move out of my way. I want it all, I want it all, I want it all, and I want it now. I want it all, I want it all, I want it all, and I want it now. Listen up.
You're now going into a class where everybody is the best. Okay? That was a great job. I see some guys really come out to rise to the challenge that we gave you at halftime, and you shoved it right down your throat. Awesome second half. Defense come up with some great big turnovers. Offense, when we needed the big play, you came through and did it. Great game. Now the fun begins.
Yeah. Hey, right now, starting from this moment, right now it's 9:56. Okay? We're not 8-2 anymore. We're not 8-2, that's over, that's in the past. Right now we're 0-0. And it starts a new season. Alright? No matter what we did up until this point in the past 10 games, it doesn't matter. Right now, we start next week, 0-0. We got something to prove to every single team we play. Alright? And we're going to go out and prove that we'll be state champions. Great second half.
All I can say, guys, congratulations. Way to come back. Way to keep your heads up.
Again, we tried to warn you this team was going to come out like gangbusters. I'll tell you what I'm really proud of is the defense, the way you guys sucked it up when it got close, ready to score. You guys all year have done that. You showed all kind of true grit, determination in there whenever it gets down there tight. You step in and you do a great job. That's what won the game for us tonight. You gave the offense a chance to come back and win this thing. Super job. Now, my coach has already took all my speech here, but we got to start getting ready.
We start getting ready right now. There's no celebrating tonight or anything like that. We've been great all year with the training rules. We stay with them. We got the second season coming up. We got five more weeks to do it. But we got to get down that a lot tougher than we did tonight to win next week. Okay? We're going all the way. Everybody in here.
Yeah.
Let's go down here and we'll go
out. Okay. One team, one goal! What do we want?
Say Joe Moses short side. Yeah.
Try to get you out of there by 10:30, 11 o'clock so you can get to church. You need to go to church. We only want the same guys who came in last week coming in. The rest of you guys, so you get to church and everything, do what you want in the morning, 8 o'clock. We're going to get that done. I have to travel up to East Jesus or someplace to get some film tomorrow, okay? We don't know where it is yet. We know we're playing Milford Center Fairbanks. They beat Bishop Reed. He's supposed to be so super, super good. All right, so what the hell am I talking about? Let's get here.
Let's go a little bit slower this time. I can't talk yet. Hey, we're going to keep it.
All right, ready?
One, two, three. evening, everybody, and welcome to Hyde Camp Stadium, home of the Warriors. But this evening, we'll have the hosting team from Fairbanks Panthers playing host as the home team to the visiting Blue Devils of Reading, Ohio. $250 per individual, offensively or defensively. This time they'll take it over the right side, breaking it 2-3, now 4 tackle. Quick pass out here looking for Vample. He's got the catch. Can he slip one? He can. He turns a corner inside the 30, the 25, the 20. We are third down to set the table, 3rd and 5. Little misdirection. Maxfield now, he'll drop back. He's rolling out to his right side. Looking back across, throws over, a heavy catch.
Oh,
the catch is made. I think touchdown.
Blue Devils.
Maxfield, all kinds of time, Dwayne, to set up and throw that football.
Maxfield got lucky that that didn't get picked up.
You don't throw
a double coverage back across there. Good thing Vample was in position to go up.
Unbelievable. This is a near capacity crowd on both sides. Both these schools well represented with fan base here tonight. He'll hit a low line driver that'll be skipped at about the 9-yard line. Straight up the gut. Oh, football loose!
The ball.
And Reading is falling on it. If I'm not mistaken, yeah, they've got the football.
Huge hit there. Bumo's trying to change it.
Focused and staying with it as they'll toss it to Wynn around the right side. Get a little bit of running room. Turns the corner. Hop!
Oh, man.
Right here, we'll see the little hop. He gets up and over.
He's got some ups.
That was Vample right there. Coffee will be split to the near side. Wynn takes it over the left side. He's trying to get to the corner. A little stiff.
Nice, what vision and balance this kid has, I'll tell you.
Nice stiff arm right there.
Right in the mush.
Right there, that's a face mask.
Yeah.
And they very odd formation. They'll give the ball straight up the gut. Nothing going. Ready defense stops that right. Good snap. Gets the kick away. Nice kick. It's going to drive Caldwell all the way back to the 31. Slips one man. Now he's at 40, 45. Looking for some. Quick three-step drop. Passes up to Vample.
Oh,
he's gone. He is gone. Charlie Vample will take it the distance.
Dave, we saw that same play last week.
Touchdown, Blue Devils.
That's a timing pattern.
Like you said, he only ain't back though. Just a couple shuffle steps.
He throws it right. Got him spun around.
Oh, he knew it too. He started high-stepping. Now they're going to roll Whale out to his non-throwing side. He's got pressure. He's going to turn around. He's hammered.
Look at that.
Whale,
he's got a scope on it. Look at him. Hello, come on back to me. There you go. Bam. Oh, where'd that guy come from?
Very different formation. They'll toss it to Wynn over the left side. Tries to turn the corner. He does. Oh, he runs over the defensive back. He keeps charging.
Boom. He's gone.
Wynn.
He's gone. See you later. Look at Charlie Vample down there running with him. Wow, what a... And they get the blocking backs out in front. They create a little alley.
Look at this.
Just a little seat. Boom.
It just ran him over. And it just...
Another one. Then here comes the Jets. Kicking the nitrous. Boom. Charlie Vample down there running with him just to make sure. Cheering his buddy on. There we go.
Split backs. They'll fake the give. Maxfield looking to pass.
Got
has
time.
A man open. The tight end makes the catch.
He
crosses the... There's Deshaun Wentz.
That's
another
in.
Tackle. Touched. What, about 20, 21 yards out? He's so strong.
He just got such a great balance.
I like that stiff arm, too.
Oh, yes. His shoulders. In this series, we're not going to see him for the rest of the evening unless necessary.
To the near side. Now he's trying to
cut
it back.
Oh,
nice job of running right there by the eye. I'm sure they're going to try to get him a touch again. That's what they do, draw him straight up the middle. He's juking and jiving. There's that stiff one. He turns the corner. Penalty flag is down. This one's going to come back, folks.
Oh,
Utah wins. Pulled out of bounds at the 25. A plethora of yellows.
What a good job by Deshaun Wynn.
And right there, they
That was a good block.
And right here, maybe a
Boy, it didn't take Deshaun long to get one.
And I think that was a wrong date. So I'm going to check that for you, folks. Keep that pencil in your hand as Whaley's scrambling for his life. Almost.
They got Gordy playing linebacker.
Deshaun Wynn split to the far side of the field. He's in double cover. Maxfield's got some room to run. Now he'll stop. Got a man in the back of the end zone. He catches it.
Yes, he got a foot down.
Got Lawson. Wynn to the far side of the field. He drew the double coverage, and Maxfield bought some extra time, and Lawson slipped behind the coverage. What a catch as he slips down and creates two
things. He got hammered. He said, now what do I do? Bam.
Once again, coming in to make the big stick, Timmy time plays in the big time games. Deshaun Wynn at his finest.
Oh, just shaking him loose. Get out of here. Now there goes the nitrous. Bam. He's gone.
Unbelievable. Deshaun Wynn feeding him grapes.
Well, we had Pat feeding him, bringing back a
heavy pressure. He's going to be brought down from behind. Third and 20.
Very good interview.
Down back, looks like they're going to try to run a screen. That's snuffed out. Big loss.
And I'll tell you, Nathan Carey was all over him there.
Tried to set that screen up. And I'll tell you what, I didn't get the number, but somebody stayed home and covered.
Yes.
Because Combs went to look that way and tried to set that screen up. And I'll tell you what, I didn't get the number, but somebody stayed home and covered.
Yes.
Because Combs went to look that way and dunk in the very first game we did so far this season. And you looked at me and I looked at you and we were like, the hair standing up on the back of the head, it's football season.
Yeah.
Gosh,
it's still there.
When you see a Clancy.
No good! But it's not over now. We celebrate tonight, we come in tomorrow ready to go, getting ready for next week. We're about 3 weeks away from running the state championship.
Woo! Oh yeah.
Something nobody's ever done. Everybody!
Down to 8 teams left in the state, boys.
Everybody tonight. The guys that filled in, Nate, get the sack. He's in the book.
Ryan York right away.
I thought we was interviewing the cheerleaders. I wouldn't be out here.
Hey, thanks a lot. You're the better looking one.
Devils versus the Blue Devils tonight.
It's the Blue Devil Bowl, here we go.
It is something. Now, I tell you, all season I've had my ICRC hat.
Well, we'll bring it up to later, although by the time they see this, it is later.
And it is later, and I tell you what, Mr. Cobwell, Tim Cobwell, and there it is, Deshaun Wynn.
Test them out.
And Deshaun.
Here
comes Mikey!
Going to get it. Oh, Rodgers just shy of the
touchdown.
Just shy of the goal line, but it's going to be a first down.
But boy, is he having a good job or doing a good job of finding those lanes?
Rodgers last.
And what a good job of that cameraman right there on the spot. These guys are
just. Well, anyway, as far as how it was thrown, but forgive
there
us
you
the
go.
Win. He's
there
got a big hole.
Nice lane.
50.
Nice lane.
45.
Oh, hit the AstroTurf. It's going to be slick. You know he's going to, Ken Miner's going to go after him here.
He's got a lane. Charlie Maple makes a nice block. Oh, she does. Very well, Bill, as their receivers get downfield and make open field blocks. Look at that Fample. He just froze him up. That guy had no chance. And 21 makes.
Max Field. The flag's up, though, and catches.
The referees gave us the little book, me and Dave. I think that helped us out a lot.
There you go.
Oh.
Max Field back to pass. He's got a one man.
Oh, he's open and he hits him. Oh, that ball hung forever. But he.
Max Field a hit. And there's Wynn.
Oh.
He's going to get fired. Great one.
Turn on the Jets. Where's the nitrous oxide? There he goes.
Sean
got one down deep.
Maxfield back to pass. He's got it open.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And Maxfield got hammered as he let that ball go. It's a play action.
I think one thing is this second half, I think Coach Meyer's going to have to get Charlie Vample more into this game.
Well, and I think we'll see that. I think he also wants to get Andy Brink more into the game, soften up them that linebacker crew. But again, this game is going to be won by who makes the better adjustments at halftime. And again, I don't think either one of them.
In the state playoffs, only the third time they've been there. And oh, a good tackle in the backfield. It's like Lee Cromer in on that, along with Tim Caldwell.
They just never let that. They never let that counter get started. Good job of the backside to mop that up quickly. They just never let that counter. See, stayed at home. Backside came, and he does a good job of just sneaking in behind the blockers. The blockers went.
But Phil, and this is.
Oh, he's out of bounds. He stopped.
Bruner, no. He didn't make it.
And they took the ref. I don't understand it myself.
That's
the same difference to me.
Bruner with the ball. Oh. There goes the referee.
Oh. Really, and as with all the players over here on Reading, is they really allude to the play of the.
Of course, Andy Brink is the tight end, and Vample is also fills in tight end. And there's Joe Tucker.
Oh, Tucker, he ain't letting the hand bother him now. That's Tucker the trucker. He's just running people over
and
where it leaves him.
He broke loose with about
boom.
6-8
Look
yards.
At that. Look at that. Look at that line play. Boom, boom. There ain't no move to that kid. He's got up that middle, and you can see how good it's been for
Tucker.
Oh,
double hand up to
reverse.
Charlie Vample.
Charlie Vample. What a block by Zach Maxfield.
Oh. This one.
Now watch this here.
There's Wynn. Oh, man,
back.
That was
now watch.
So
here
quick.
It goes. Here it goes. Boom. He takes a shot. Oh, and that makes the play. Good job of Brookville staying home. We got to do something now.
Well, I agree. I agree with Gil on it. I'm surprised they called timeout, too. I think they'd be happy to keep that clock moving. But nevertheless, Vample and Coffey lined up wide. Two backs behind Maxfield. Big play for Reading. He's got. Oh,
he's the hook and ladder! The hook and ladder! That's a touchdown! Oh, my God! Yeah! The hook and ladder to Deshaun! Oh, what a play! Good Kenny Meyer! You are an unworthy great play! Oh, yeah!
Connor trying to put on point number 26. It's up. It's good.
Oh, and these people are running on corner bananas. We got 2:44 left. But more importantly about that timeout, Bill. Now, they've only got two timeouts left over for Brookville.
Here it is again.
Oh, look at that.
Look at that. Perfect. They're strike to him, and he was on the run.
Oh,
unbelievable.
They were playing soft and not even looking for it. No safety help. Oh, Kenny Miner. Oh, what? Oh, look at that.
Look at that. Perfect. They're strike to him, and he was on the run. Oh, unbelievable. Here it is again.
Oh,
Oh, look at that.
Look at that.
Perfect. Oh. Right to him, and he was on the run. Oh. Unbelievable.
They were playing soft and not even looking for it.
The crowd speaks for itself. And I tell you what, I just said hats off to Mark Gibson and the Brookville Blue Devils. They had a tremendous season this year. They have nothing to be ashamed about. They did a really great job. We congratulate them.
Exactly. But, oh, there comes that. Here comes the hardware.
But you know what? They said the kids have been wearing shirts at Reading this week. The real Reading Blue Devils. Well, we know who the real Reading Blue Devils, are. Okay, well, Gil is going to be going down on the field. He's going to be catching up with Coach Miner and some of the players. And
well, who do we give our game ball to?
Oh, I don't know. We've been thinking about it all night.
Deshaun for sure on the offense and that offensive line. What a job they did. On the defensive side of the ball, wow. I don't know.
I don't know. I'm not sure either. We'll think about it. I tell you what, let's step out for a moment. We got to settle down up here. We're going to go down to Gil for a post game. We'll be right back. The Reading Blue Devils are going to the semifinals of the state. Bill Bretz and the entire ICRC crew will be seeing you.
Welcome down to the field. We're down here with Coach Miner, Deshaun, and Charlie Vample. Guys, just an exciting victory. I mean, I don't even live in your community. I'm so excited. I'm ready to jump out of my skin. I know you have to be thrilled. Congratulations, Coach Miner.
Let me tell you about that last play. I was up the state tournament about 3 years ago, and it's 2 years, I guess, so Lebanon scored on a hook and ladder. I saw two more games scored on hook and ladder, Coldwater, I think it was, and I thought, boy, it'd be a great time to do it. But I'm lying, because you know why we ran that hook and ladder? Because of Deshaun. Deshaun told me, Coach, it's time for the hook and ladder. Said, we won a game, big game, at Lachlan when I was a freshman on it. Now's the time to run it. I went out to the huddle, and I said, boys, I think they saw Deshaun doing the hook and ladder, so I'm worried that they're going to be thinking it's coming. And I said, what about the middle screen? Nah, I don't know, guy. The lineman said, I don't know, Coach. And I said, when we scored on the hook and ladder, guys? And he says, sure, we can. He says, when I scored on the hook and ladder, at Lachlan was the number one we threw it to that pitched it to me. So I said, that's good enough for me. That's one the hook and ladder. Yeah, these are guys that did it, not me. I didn't do a thing.
Well, it was an exciting way to score. And I was pointing out to Dwayne and Bill up in the booth, would you have called that play had Brookville not called that timeout? I said, why are they calling a timeout? Giving you a chance to set up the play to win the ball game.
That's the play we had coming in. If they didn't call that, it would have been still in there if they didn't call that timeout. So that was the same play we would have used, yes.
Great, great. Charlie, excellent job out there today. Unofficially, I had you for two catches for 20 yards and the most exciting play of not only this game, but many games that we've seen in a while. How'd it feel to pull that off?
Oh, God, it's amazing, man. We ran that play all day in practice, every day. It got messed up every time. Then he gave Coach Miner the confidence to run it. I told Zach just not to throw it too low and not catch it. If you threw it high enough, it don't matter how high. Zach did a great job getting it up there. I saw Deshaun coming. My eyes got real big, and I just pitched it to Deshaun. He just held on the sidelines, gone. I was excited.
Well, great job, Charlie. Deshaun, unofficially, I had you tonight with 203 yards, a little bit less than last week. But you did a great, great job, I think, of controlling the ball. In fact, you know, that seemed like one of the main ways you could stop their offense was keep the ball in your hands and keep your drives going.
Well, during the first quarter, it went by so fast because they ate up most of the clock. We ate up most of it because we were all running the ball. And the game seemed to go by so fast, we knew we had to take advantage of the drives, the series that we got. We only got like five apiece, I think. So we just had to try to score as many times as we could.
Yes, and we were talking before, we felt like whoever had the ball last was going to score and we're going to win this ball game, and that's exactly what you do. Gentlemen, congratulations. I didn't realize it when Bill was talking to Coach Miner earlier. Here we go. We've got the regional championship trophy right here with us. Hopefully we can go with you next week to the state semifinals. I guess we've been somewhat of a good luck charm for you. That makes us feel real good. Congratulations on tonight's win. Good luck next week in the state semifinals, gentlemen. Back up to you, Bill and Dwayne.